everyone, I'm Shruti and I live in Singapore. And today, I'm making a popular breakfast and a snack item from the state of Gujarat. It is called dhokla, as we all know it. We have different types of dhoklas, but today I'm making you a quick one. Let's get cooking. So let's begin the instant rava dhokla. Rava is nothing but semolina. So what I have done is, I have taken a cup of semolina and I have mixed it with a cup of sour yogurt. And I have let this mixture rest for about 20 to 25 minutes. And the semolina, as you can see, has fluffed up with all the yogurt. So now what we have to do is just add a few spices and a few ingredients and it's done, because it's that instant. So now what I'm going to do is, I have crushed ginger and green chili, and I have just roughly made a paste here. So I'm going to take about a teaspoon of it, as you can see. So it's a very coarsely done paste. I'm going to add a teaspoon of salt, and I'm going to add a teaspoon of sugar. And I'm just going to mix this nicely, and I'm going to thin this out with a little bit of water. So I'm going to take about a quarter cup as of now, and I'm going to slowly add this, not the whole water. So I'm just going to mix this lightly, and you have to make it like an idli batter, that is like a pancake batter. So it has to be thick, but a little bit on the softer side. I'll add a little more. I have not yet used up all the 1/4 cup that I have taken. This is a bit like the idli batter. So I did not use up all the 1/4, but it depends on how runny your yogurt is. Make sure the yogurt is thick and you can then balance it out with the water. So now this is the consistency that we want. It's like a thick but a little runny. And now we will get to steaming this. So we have ready this batter, and now why I call it instant is, I'm going to add a sachet of Eno fruit salt, but if you do not have this, please add baking soda to this. And here I have the dhokla plates. So traditionally it's made in these, because they are nothing but plates just arranged in order, and I have greased them with oil. You can take any pie plate that you have or any dish that is a slightly 2 to 3 inch deep, and you can steam it in a deep pan or any vessel that you have with some water under it. So what I'm going to do is, I have kept some water boiling in a pot, and I'm going to instantly mix this and pour it in these plates. And once you pour the Eno, you have to immediately put it to steam. So I'm going to take a teaspoon of Eno, but with the baking soda, you can take about a 3/4 teaspoon of baking soda. So and you will see that the minute I start whisking this, it's going to start foaming up. So mix it lightly. Do not mix this very vigorously, but make sure you're mixing it well. And you can see that it started bubbling up. So now I'm just going to pour this in the plates. So now the water is boiling, and I'm going to add this stand, and I'm going to close this and steam this for exactly 12 minutes. So now we have finished our 12 minutes, and it's quite hot. I'm going to just let this rest, and the dhokla has come out really nice and fluffy. I ended up using one plate, because that one cup was enough for this one plate. I'm just going to let this rest. Also, I'm going to show you another option where I have used a pan and I have kept a small plate ulta. So I'm going to just keep a vessel. So you can grease this vessel and you can steam the dhoklas even this way. So I'm just showing you this option for reference, and that is in case you don't have the dhokla stand. So I have removed the dhokla and cooled it down, and I have inverted my plate, and the dhokla has come out really easily, and this is how it looks. I'm going to get to seasoning the dhokla now. I'm going to temper it with some spices, a teaspoon of mustard seeds, a teaspoon of cumin seeds, half a teaspoon of sesame seeds, and I'm going to add some green chilies. I'm going to add a few curry leaves, a little bit of hing, that is asafoetida. So I'm just going to swirl this and pour it over my dhokla. And I'm going to garnish with a little bit of fresh coriander as well. So I'm going to cut it into big squares. Let me show you how soft and fluffy it has become. So it's cooked well and it's nice and fluffy. So I'm just going to continue this, and I'm going to plate this and see you on the other side.
And the rava dhokla is ready in literally 15 to 20 minutes. And here I have served it with some green coriander chutney. You can have this with whatever you like. And try this and make this quick snack. Enjoy this yummy breakfast. And let me know how you like it. Keep watching all my recipes. Thanks for watching.